Thank you, Vicki. Good evening, everyone. As Vicki mentioned, my name is Isla Vassallo, and myself, along with Valerie Brown and Deb Hammond, work on the Government Policy and Relations Committee for TCS. We have an exciting lineup for tonight's policy portion of the agenda, so let's get started. I'm honored to introduce and will be talking with Burlington County Commissioner Linda Hines. Ms. Hines is a lifelong resident of Burlington County. She received her associate's degree from Burlington County College in criminal justice and her bachelor's degree in political science from Rutgers University, Camden. She attended Widener Law School in Delaware, where she earned her Juris Doctorate. Linda has been practicing law for over 20 years and has focused her career on advocating for women and children in the Burlington County court system. Linda also had the distinct honor of being appointed by the New Jersey Supreme Court to the Ethics Committee in Burlington County, where she investigated and prosecuted allegations of attorney misconduct for 8 years. Linda has a passion for public service, serving 5 years on the Board of Education in her hometown of Westampton. And she was next elected to the Westampton Township Committee in 2017 and served 2 years as deputy mayor. As a county commissioner, Linda serves as liaison to elections, prosecutor, resource conservation, and schools. Good evening, Ms. Hines, and welcome.
Thank you so much. I'm so happy to be here with all of you.
Great. So to start off, I wanted to find a little bit more out about Burlington County and the general resource conservation there. It's the biggest county in the state of New Jersey, covering over 800 miles. Can you provide some resource conservation statistics for Burlington, like preserved farmland, open space, miles of hiking trails, things like that?
Absolutely. I would love to brag about Burlington County. So we have 204 miles of trails in our county. We have 13 county parks. That's 100,000 acres of developed parklands. And we have marked 3,500 acres for future parkland development. We maintain 7 museums and galleries, 3 regional trail projects. We have an extremely active open space preservation program. So when municipalities find a piece of property within their district that they feel should be preserved, we partner with them so they're able to preserve that for open space. But we are especially proud of our farmland preservation program. So let me just brag a little bit. So we are number one in the state in total acreage of preserved farmland. We're second in the state for the total number of farms preserved. I think this one is my favorite. We are number 7 in the nation. So that's all of the nation. Burlington County is 7th for total farmland acreage preservation. And we are the oldest preserved farmland preservation program in the state. So I am very proud of those statistics. And just before we jump to the next question, I'm very honored to be presenting with Commissioner Jeff Nash, such a seasoned public official. I have been on the job as a commissioner for 15 months. So I have a little less service than him, but I would say what a 15 months it's been. So if we're going, I think I get a little couple, it's almost like dog years, but very, very honored just to be presenting with him.
Okay, well, we know that open space preservation and things like regenerative farming are very important. We're learning as it comes to climate change. So that's wonderful things to hear in terms of open space preservation. So I'm on the Evesham Environmental Commission, and we had the pleasure of your attendance at our March meeting. And you told us about a new initiative that you're spearheading called Equity in the Outdoors. Can you tell us a little more about that?
I would love to. Last summer, I attended a seminar held by the Pinelands Preservation Alliance, and it was an African-American environmentalist and his journey out of the inner city to become a wildlife refuge conservatives. And his story was just so captivating. And it was a time when all of us are really taking a very hard and difficult look at systemic racism. So I started doing my own research and found that the users of our county parks do not resemble what the diversity of our county is. I changed forever. I'm going to promote this book, Black Faces, White Spaces. It will change your life. So I asked my resource conservation department to really, let's look at that. So let's look at access. So how do we get those majority minority communities to our county park? So we're taking a look at our transportation system. We're having listening sessions, which require very uncomfortable, awkward conversations, but they're necessary. We are having events. We just opened our brand new park, which is Willingboro Lakes, which is absolutely spectacular if you haven't been. And we're working with Willingboro leadership because we're trying to ascertain how we can best serve the community to make sure that our natural resources are available to all. Burlington County created a few months ago the first ever County Diversity and Equality Task Force. So I have put this issue on their horizon, and we are partnering with our departments to take a look at that. And sometimes it's simple as just the messaging. When one of our employees at the Resource Conservation was putting together some PR work, she was going through the old county stock photos. And it was absolutely astounding that not one of those photos shows a family of color enjoying our county parks. Unacceptable. So it's just simply something as easy as changing the messaging. We're flipping it all upside down. So stay tuned. And anyone with ideas, I'm trying to attend and talk with anyone who has ideas on this topic. But it's something that now when we are planning anything in resource conservation, we always check off sustainability. And now we're checking off this new box, which is equity in the outdoors. Is this serving all of the residents? So it's something that I'm hopeful to make some progress. Am I going to solve the problem? Absolutely not. But I'm hoping to at least begin those conversations during my tenure so we can really start to move the needle.
Oh, that sounds really good. And my TCS colleague, Patrick, just put a link to that book in our chat so people can find that.
I get there. No money off this. I get no royalties off the promotion. It will change your life.
Okay. And I would say it's fair to say that we're all looking forward to spring this year. So with the weather getting warmer, do you expect to see more spotted lanternflies than in the previous 2 years? And what, if anything, can residents do about that?
So I have become known throughout the county as the bug lady, which is not the nicest. I'm trying to flip it to the ladybug, but I have been talking everywhere and anywhere about spotted lanternflies and scraping the egg casings. These despicable little insects that plagued us before are going to become even more of a problem. I don't think anyone is really grasped the problem that they are going to be. So the county, we have started our Beat the Bug campaign because every campaign needs a catchy title. And we have been promoting on ABC News, KYW News Radio, making videos about how easy it is to just, while you're on your walk, while you take your children to the playground, to spot. Because everyone thinks they're these big cocoons hanging out of the tree and they say, I didn't see any. And you would never know what they were. They look like they're a part of the tree. They're very conspicuous. You would not see them. So every Saturday, the county has held scraping Saturdays. What else would you want to do on a Saturday morning than come out and scrape some egg casings? But we've been doing that. We've been giving service credit hours to all of our Girl Scouts and Boy Scouts, or children making their confirmation or bar mitzvah that need these service credit hours. So I'm proud to report that we do have a form on the park's website, and we ask that if you scrape these egg casings, you actually report to us where you scraped, so we know not to focus our efforts, and about how many egg casings. Now, most people don't report. They're out there just scraping as they're taking their dog for a walk or something. But as of Thursday, we have surpassed 200,000 estimated spotted lanternflies that the volunteers in Burlington County have scraped. So again, I'm even going out to residents' house to say, I think these are in my tree, and I've been driving around the county, even just walking up and showing them that it is or is not one. But we are asking everyone, and I think really that the support we've had from the community is everyone's on board with this. Because if nothing, they love to feast on hops and grapevines. So those that like to enjoy a glass of wine or a beer, you have a vested interest in making sure you get out there and scrape these little despicable insects.
Okay, that's great. And it sounds like your campaign is off to an extremely good start with that many egg scrapings. I personally have to get out there and do that. So, okay, I'm going to switch a little bit from resource conservation to more policy related question. But as most of us know, the state's new stormwater management rules went into effect at the beginning of March. So do these rules have any impact at the county level? And if so, how?
So they certainly do. So in Burlington County, our county planning board is actually the review agency for our stormwater management practices. So certainly the municipalities all submitted, almost all of them now have officially submitted their new plans, which have been accepted. The new rules, again, the county engineer will be the most impacted by the new stormwater management rules with regard to his road projects. We feel in park development, we must also comply with the new rules. However, we are in a much better position to incorporate green infrastructure into a park or a trail design because that's our natural tendency anyway. So certainly it will be impactful, but at resource conservation, we feel that it's something that we've always been striving for anyway. And so I am not Rhodes. So that is another liaison. So I didn't want to step over toes to go to our county engineer, but I was assured that Joe Brickley, our county engineer, is well-versed in the new stormwater management rules and it will be making the appropriate adjustments.
Great. Thank you for that information. From a sustainability perspective, what ways do you see Burlington County embracing sustainability at the county level? And in addition to the recycling that is already done?
So everything in the resource conservation department is done with an eye towards sustainability. Some of our new projects that are happening this year, I'm excited to tell you about. So we just applied for a very exciting new grant with the New Jersey American Water Grant. And basically we'll be able to turn the water fountains at some of our county parks into water bottle refilling stations. And actually, I met with a third grade class who wrote to me and had some ideas, and that was one of them. And so actually, we are going to name the project after this third grade class that has received a certificate. But that's something that's very exciting. We're going to start with a handful of county parks and see how it goes, and then hopefully spread from there. Also, very exciting news. The county was approached by a few local Starbucks franchises who offered their coffee grounds for our composting at the Agricultural Center in Morristown. And so I looked a little into this because it came out to me, well, apparently this is a national thing that Starbucks does, that they will even bag up coffee grounds for residents who have, you know, have composting. So we are trying to take that further. We're looking at other composting areas in the county. We plan on making and promoting videos for residents about composting. Starbucks is helping us with that, and they're on board completely. So if you've never looked into it, it's something that they came to us, and it seems like it's just a wonderful partnership. And another exciting something just came up. I was approached by two Girl Scouts that are going for their Silver Award. And their project is pizza box recycling. So they have actually partnered with local farmers who are going to be, it always bothers me that the pizza boxes go into the trash and not recycling. So they, the county, I heard about this, I met with the girls, and now we are accepting the pizza boxes at some of our locations. And then we used our network of farmers who are going to be accepting them. And that has been sparking a lot of conversation with our recycling department. So hopefully, I don't want Cam to scoop me, I'm just kidding. But we have some exciting ideas that we're trying to look into with regard to pizza box recycling. And finally, just another thing I'm proud about is we're changing all of our aluminum signs throughout the county as we change to the Board of County Commissioners instead of Freeholder to 100% recycled e-waste and textile waste material called E-Straight. So that's something that started with our farmland preservation signs, and now the county has taken on. And so we're starting to use that material in all of our signs.
That's great. And I think we're close to wrapping up our time here, but a real quick final question is, at our last TCS general meeting, we had a virtual tour of Camden County's Office of Sustainability, And could you see Burlington County creating a similar office or role?
I surely can. And we are actually in the process of updating our open space preservation program, as well as some other, really taking a whole overhaul of our resource conservation department. That is something that I certainly would like to see. As I said, everything that we do, every park, every trail, every project in Burlington County, we do have an eye on sustainability, but it would certainly be nice to have someone filling that role. And while budgets are always an issue, but there's certainly ways I think that we can make that happen. It may not be a short-term plan, but it is something in the long-term vision for Burlington County.
Well, I just wanted to thank you again so much for your time this evening, Commissioner Hines. It's great to hear all the initiatives that are in progress in the county of Burlington, and I hope you'll come back to give us updates in the future.
Absolutely. Thank you so much.
Okay.